about the Dr. Steve Wagner, and now I'm going to introduce Mike Suris.
Just Mike.
Yeah.
Just Mike.
Just Mike. Steve for sure.
Started in working in his father's lab at the age of 16. Even when doing maintenance and entry-level jobs, he knew this was where he wanted to be. After high school, he attended Indiana University State and earned a degree in dental technology from IU School of Dentistry. Upon returning to the family business, Michael was assigned the task of developing new products and technology. These include all ceramic products, computerization of the laboratory systems. This naturally progressed to the utilization of today's modern CAD-CAM systems. Michael is in the lab, beta tester trainer and advocate for Sirona's in-lab Ceric and Ceric Connect products. Michael and his wife run the CAD Plus Advanced Training Center near Chicago. He travels extensively throughout the United States for Dentspy Sirona speaking, demonstrating training and troubleshooting. Michael is president of the Dental Professionals Labs Incorporated. Thank you, Michael. Enjoy your presentation.
Thank you. Kind of rough, aren't they?
That's what I mean. I'm kind of worried. I'm sitting a little.
Rough night, guys? Or no. Who wants an House of Blues? Anyway? Good time?
It was a good
time. I couldn't do it. But 11 o'clock last night, my wife said, I'm going to go. I said, well, if you want to go, you can go. I'm going back.
Done.
I'm tapping out. So, glad you guys made it this morning. It's good to see you here. So, we're going to talk to you a little bit today about the Dentspy Sirona digital solution for dentures. We've teamed up with AvaDent, great company to work with. I've been very impressed. Previous to this, I'd say I was not very impressed with AvaDent. I did. But they've really showed me, okay, this is going to work. Very well. So, we just started here. The doc talked a little bit about this.
Well, I mean, I think this picture is really apropos. The history of modern denture making goes back to 1850 with the invention of compound by a fellow named Stent, the same guy that's named for the arterial stent. So we have a long history. Unfortunately, for some reason, denture making got quick frozen in 1952. And the way we make dentures then, the way my father was trained to make dentures, is the way my children would be taught to make dentures now. For some reason, that just sort of caught my throat, and I didn't like the idea. In about 2000, I tried to develop techniques based on the history of denture making and all the craftsmanship that goes into the work that we do, and design it for the new dentist that's coming out of dental school that has very poor training in denture making. But they're the key person for driving the systems, bringing patients in. I've tried to develop a technique that would allow us to make dentures in a simplified way that you could teach your customers to do that would allow them to make a denture and feel comfortable making a denture. So that's really going to be the theme that I talk about today. It was my great luck that I was able to take some of those experiences that I developed in the early 2000s, take them to AvaDent, take them to Dentspy Sirona, and they have allowed me to kind of develop this into a 21st century process. So that'll be kind of the underlying story from my side. Mike has a tremendous background in digital technology, and so we're going to try to blend the two up here today.
I got to go back to what you said earlier, and you mentioned your father.
Right.
And yesterday you mentioned your grandfather.
My grandfather was a dentist.
Third generation.
Well, I actually lied. My grandfather was a candy salesman, so that. But I thought he was part of the process.
I see. I got okay. Now I'm on to you. All right. So.
But the other thing is that it's interesting. Dentspy Sirona really started with TrueGuide back in World War I time period. A fellow named J. Leon Williams, picture of him up in the upper left, a photographer of note, an artist, and a dentist, was the fellow that started developing the concepts of aesthetics of round, tapering, square teeth. That all came from Dr. Williams. So Dentspy has really been paralleling their career all the way through the development of dentures since the first of the 20th century.
Right. I love the I know it's not a Facebook, but that was quite a contraption on there on the face. That was really kind of cool. So now, 100 years later, what's changed? Not a whole lot. So we're still doing the same denture setups. We're doing the same press pack or injection. Just not a whole lot of advancement as of yet. So what's the prognosis? Where are we going with dentures? So I thought dentures were going away. Implants are going to replace them, right? That's what we keep hearing. Doctors might say, nah, I don't do dentures. I just do implants.
And never see a denture. That's what they'll tell you. They never see a denture.
I just want to do implants. Single tooth implants. Average total cost, $4,000 for one tooth. Think about it. One tooth. No wonder the doctors like to do them. How about an all-on-four? Top and bottom supported dentures? From $25,000 to $95,000. Do one for the year, I'm done. Right?
Covered it. We're good.
With the steep growth, we know that we're aging. The baby boomers are getting older. But we're going to need more dentures. And the rates are going to increase for the edentulous. Adults need dentures, 1 to 2 arches, will increase from 33.6 million to 91 to 37.9 million in 2020. That's quite an increase. And where our dental care is supposed to be getting better, the number of edentulous cases are going up. So according to, okay, guys, no calculators here. We're going to test your math, okay? Here we go. 35 million edentulous or partially edentulous people in the United States. 90% of them are edentulous. 35 million times 0.9%, 31,500,000 people have some type of a prosthesis, currently have some type of prosthesis. 31.5 million people estimated that approximately 15% will get a new denture this year. So how many people are getting a new denture? Very close.
He's the first one to ever do
that. Very close. Very close. Impressive. 4,725,000 new dentures this year. Okay? So this year we're going to do that many. That's just the United States. Average lab cost is $245. That's average cost. Mine is higher. Okay? 4,725,000 new dentures. That's a $1.2 billion industry. Approximately 6,584 labs, 1.2 million divided by 6,584, $182,260 per lab. Now please realize, of the 6,584 labs, less than half of those are denture labs. So that number you can even go out further. So there's money to be made in this. It is a $1.2 billion industry, dentures, removable. So, It's a key part of our industry. Who benefits, Doc? Tell us who benefits from the
dental. Well, I'm going to look at it from the dental standpoint right now. As I kind of alluded to before, the traditional way we make dentures, the way dental students learn to make dentures now, if taken to a private practice, makes it impossible for them to make a profit. It's just too much time and labor in a dental office to make things work. Digital dentistry offers the promise of cutting chair time. We're going to discuss, we're talking 5 appointments to 3 appointments. Something that a dentist can make a 3-appointment denture and be able to feed their family. So that's a big thing. The technique to make a denture, as we all know in this room, is a craft, it's a hand skill. And it's something that you develop over time, just like a cabinet maker learns to make a better cabinet with 20 years of experience. We need to simplify the technique for the new dentist so that they can make the denture. So digital dentistry offers simplified potential also. If you're able to make dentures, they can attract patients. Young dentists need patients. There's a pool of people out there that aren't being treated. This allows them to treat them. The accuracy of digital dentistry is equal to the accuracy of fixed work, and we know how accurate that is. And it changes everything in a denture. The dentures stay in better, they're more supportive, the patient appreciates a lot more. Also, a digital denture could be duplicated with just another order of a denture. So that's important for a lot of patients, nursing home patients, for instance. That's a big deal. So we have a permanent digital record, and it's been shown that there are less post-insertion adjustments with digital dentures. Typical denture technique, 5 appointments. Typical follow-up, 5 appointments. If we can lessen all of that, we've made a significant effect for a dentist.
Well, with the increased accuracy, I think that's a big one that people kind of they're missing with the digital. Is how many people are press packing dentures? So, what happens with acrylic being press packed?
Shrinks.
You have a gap underneath it. Now we're going to mill it. There's no gap. It matches the palate.
Now, how about post dams?
Okay, great question. It's debatable now. I put post dams in. Mike puts post dams in. We don't know if you have to, but for me, I think anything that makes the denture stronger or more retentive is better. And if they don't want to post dam, it's easier to grind it off and put it on.
AvaDent tells us we don't need them.
Yeah.
Okay, they say you don't need them. I put it in there because I would rather have it there and be able to grind it off than the doctor said, no, I want it added in.
So what type of impression then you take?
We'll get on.
Hey, this guy is
he's on it.
You got a fiver coming for you right now. We're going to talk about that.
He's not a plant, okay? We didn't put him there.
Promise to the patient. It really duplicates the promise that goes to the dentist. Fewer appointments, very important for anybody that's busy. The aesthetics of these teeth, as you'll see next door after we get done, is exquisite. The dentures are as good as any denture you'll ever see. So that will sell the case to the patient. Accuracy means better fit, and it really just creates an overall better patient experience. A happy patient will be a patient that will draw somebody else into the practice. So it's got a lot of benefits from that standpoint, as far as I'm concerned.
You know, the improved patient experience. I was lucky enough, fortunate enough, that when I got out of lab school, I had to do an internship somewhere. And I could have gone back to the family lab and done it there, but my father said, no, you need to go do it somewhere else. And it was Evansville, Indiana. It was an old guy named Morris Claudel. Great guy, I believe he's passed now. But he really taught me something that I was doing base plates and bite rims. And okay. He says, you really need to make them great. And it's like, why? It's just a base plate and bite rim. He says, that's that patient's first experience.
Right.
It makes it to where, you put it in and it feels good, it looks good, even though it's a bite rim. So increasing that patient experience is very important. So if we can make everything through this whole thing better for them, everybody's happy.
I would agree.
So for the lab, what's in it for us? What promises for us? New product offers. I love new products. I love to have stuff in market and go talk to the doctors about it. Now I can go in the doc, look at this. Now I'm going to make your life so easy. I got something for you. So, and it's a simplified process. I mean, I'll tell you, I'm not a denture guy. I'm Crown & Bridge. That's my thing. Crown & Bridge implants. That's my forte, if you will. My wife is the denture person. My wife is the all-around technician. She does it all.
To be honest.
Honestly, she does it all. So I don't think she's in here. So, so anyway, I can do this. I've done dentures for years. I dread doing it. But this system's easy. It's easy to do. I can do it. A Crown & Bridge person can do it. Just about anybody can do this. Fast turnaround. I can put these on pretty quick because the labor's so low that we can flip these real quick. Lower remakes is always good for us. We all hate the remakes. Increase efficiency, so it's just very smooth workflow, very easy to transition into. Predictability, I know what's coming back. I know, I can predict this. I'm not worried about it. I'm not worried about porosity in my dentures because I didn't put enough acrylic in the flask. So, and a cleaner, smaller footprint. Something we got to look at as laboratories is how much rent are you paying? You say, well, I own my building. Well, you're still paying rent. Okay, you're renting your building or your space by the foot. And how much are you paying per foot? And So when you can condense stuff down into a smaller space and make yourself more efficient, your profits go up. So with this, I can eliminate my boil off tank. Okay? I can eliminate the processing tank. I can eliminate denture flex, plaster bed. All that stuff is gonna move on.
But that brings up a point. And something from the outside is the dentist looking at your work, is you can take a fixed lab and turn it into a fixed removable lab
very easily
without any added equipment. It's all digital now, it's all milling, it's all scanning. Suddenly you're a full service lab with fixed equipment. To me, that struck me as maybe the biggest thing.
You know, CAD CAM in a hole, and with Dentspy Sirona, we can give you a solution as a denture lab to make combination cases and step into the crown and bridge, and we can give you now crown and bridge to step into dentures. Mm-hmm. Very easy. Expand the products, the things that you can offer your doctors. How many of you guys send cases out? Well, I don't do the denture part, so I have to send that to the guy's lab down the street. Well, now I can bring this in, take that over. So let's get started. Getting started with Dentspy Sirona, AvaDent Digital Dentures. I was asked to come to the national sales meeting a couple of weeks ago, and the big thing was, you gotta say Dentspy Sirona. Dentspy Sirona, not just Sirona. For years I said Sirona, Sirona, Sirona. So I catch myself still.
You're doing the best you can.
So I might slip up a little bit here, but I'll try and keep it up. So for the doctor.
All right, this is a big thing in what we were alluding to. The five appointment technique that's tradition in dentistry. Preliminary impressions, final impressions, records, try-in, and fit. It doesn't fit the paradigm of today's contemporary office. If we can get it down, and I'm going to show you how to do it, we can make impressions the first appointment, we can take records the second, and deliver the denture the third. That's a big, big deal for your dentist. And if you're the lab in your community that can offer it, that's a big advantage for you, I feel. Would you agree?
Absolutely. For the lab, we're going to go from four to three. So the last step, the fifth step, is usually the doctor's step. But where I'm going to go from modeling and bite rooms and all this stuff, denture setups, which I dread, I can do them, but it takes a long time.
Right.
They're not pretty. So where I can eliminate that part of it and simply do a scan of the impression, not even pour the model, just scan the impression. So that's impressive. Scan design, do a try-in. Right now, AvaDent's gonna create the try-in for me, but pretty soon, the summer, we'll be able to do them in-house ourselves if we want to. Then design, mill, and finish the final denture. So there's two ways of doing that. We'll talk about both ways. I'm really excited about the milling in-house, but it's coming, we're working on it. The clinical appointment one.
Yeah, so now we're giving you an overview of digital dentistry kind of from a mile high. I'm gonna talk about some specific techniques that I like to use that will get me to that three appointment step. Now, the traditional way of making impressions requires two appointments, at least an extended length appointment. First appointment is preliminary impressions, custom tray, final impressions. I've developed an impression tray that allows you to make a textbook quality final impression in one appointment and with practice in one 30-minute appointment. I'm not going to show you the details, but basically it's a thermoplastic tray that's warmed in hot water chair side. The dentist places it into the patient's mouth and they go through border molding motions. That shapes the tray. It can fundamentally change the shape of the tray to fit the qualities of a final impression. Then I take it out, chill it in water. This is not done with flame, it's just with warm water and cold water. Then I apply caulk Aquasil fast set rigid for border molding. Now, this tray could be border molded in any way you want to, your dentist wants to do it. The impression can be made in any way they want to do it. But with this material, you can border mold in about 1 minute. typically it sets in about three, so you can order mold in a minute, take it out, let it bench set for three, and you could actually give a classic border molding, get a classic border molded tray in about a minute and a half. Next slide. Okay, so we border molded with rigid. I put some in the middle. Any place that the tray shows through, any little spots here or there, I take it and grind it out with a carbide burr, just shape it. I could also create relief, traditional relief in the tray also. Then I take caulk Aquasil, a Dentspy Sirona product, LV, light viscosity, and then I do my wash in that. Again, that's a 3-minute set. I put it in the mouth personally, 2 minutes, take it out, let it bench set for the third. So it's been in the patient's mouth only 3 minutes versus, as you know, with rubber base, 6 minutes to 8 minutes. So it's a better patient experience. And these are very, very accurate impressions, as accurate as you need.
This is on the first visit.
This is the first visit.
We're gonna eliminate the custom tray.
Right. That's right. We've eliminated that process, which has saved an appointment. We've gone from 5 to 4 now. The next thing we're going to do, appointment one, is have the dentist make a measurement of the distance between the incisive papilla and the resting lip. We know that when a person's lip is resting, you can see the tip of the incisal edges of the central incisors. Well, we're going to take that measurement and use that to create a device that will allow the dentist to go through an accelerated process, appointment two. So this is a papillometer reading. So here we have it placed on the incisive papilla. He rests the lip. Let's see that next one. You can see right here, at rest, the lip is maybe 12, 13 millimeters. Your dentist records that. Then you have the patient smile, drawing the lip up, and you measure that length. This is 4 millimeters in this patient. That information is going to be passed back through your lab to AvaDent, and they're going to create a device that will allow us to accelerate appointment two.
So we got lip line and high lip line.
Yep. Third thing we're going to do is we're going to select teeth. We're going to select our portrait mold and our portrait shade. That's going to go into our prescription, and that'll be passed back to you, and that will be used to create this, we're going to call it an easy guide for appointment two.
Okay, I got a problem.
Yeah.
I don't do portrait, I don't do mold selection.
Okay, yeah, and a lot of dentists don't. They rely on you to do it.
Right, and are we only stuck with portrait?
Well, I prefer portrait. The question is, are you stuck with portrait? I don't use the word stuck, number one. It's a great tooth. If you're working with the Dentspy Sirona system, we recommend one of the teeth that they provide.
You have different doctors that want different types of teeth.
Yeah, I think that can be accommodated. Okay. Question was, can you use other teeth? The answer is yes. But in my practice, this is what I use.
Well, the way the system's set up right now, it's portrait teeth.
Yeah. And there's going to be some real reason when you come over and see the milled system that AvaDent has, and we're going to talk about that here in a second. It's using the same IPN resin that portrait teeth are made from, so you can match teeth much easier.
And AvaDent will help me select the mold and everything I need there. So.
Are we going to be using alma gauge for this to find out how far you're going to go?
We're not going to use it. The question was, are you going to use an alma gauge? Does everybody know what an alma gauge is? It's a device for measuring the position of the central incisor on an existing denture. It's a little device, it's a clever little device that measures it. You could use that as an aid for sure. It's not necessary for the process.
Digital impressions. We're done with impressions, right? We're gonna go digital. Let's get rid of it. Let's throw out that impression material. Unfortunately, not yet. Okay, there's an issue with digital impressions and scanning. I love the Crown and Bridge scans. If I could convert my lab 100% to it, I would do it today. But and the problem is it's soft tissue. Soft tissue is mobile. Okay, so it moves. Consequently, distortions. think about scanning in the mouth, the doctor pulls that cheek a little bit to get a little better view, and all that tissue moves with it. Now it's distorted. With an impression, you're saying it.
Well, yeah, and with an impression, you're really doing two things, aren't you? You're making, impressing the shape of the tissue, but you're also displacing tissue. The vestibule is just a potential space until you spread it. Someday they will have digital edentulous scanning, but I don't think it's here yet. And I know people are actively working on it. I would say you're scanning a well-made impression. That's digital.
Somewhere in Bentheim, Germany, the center of innovation, they got somebody in a back room working on this. I bet on it. But right now, we're just not ready for it. We need the impression to stabilize everything to get it accurate for dentures.
Right.
So soft tissue is a problem. So we'll talk about the digital denture scanning workflow and why, you know, when we can't scan with an intraoral, why are we calling it digital? So scanning, impressions and models. We could scan either one with a laboratory scanner at this point. It says intraoral there, but intraoral is not possible at this point. I don't know when, but it will come. So what scanners can we use? The Dentspy Sirona INEOS X5 Intelligent Robotic Scanner is my favorite. I really like this one. I like it because it's very simple to use, very accurate, and if I don't position the impression just right on the tray or the model, I can still fill in missing images. Very easy, I don't have to start over. Very easy to use, excellent scanner. Three-shaped dental wings also work very well. Good scanners also. I won't knock them. They're good. They're popular out there. And just about any scanner that can put out a STL file will work. So we're going to select models and scan it in. I'm going to simply mount the impression on the tray. I know I've talked to them. We're working on an impression holder. Right now we're just going to use that blue tap poster hanger stuff to mount and hold it in place. Again, it's a five-axis arm, so it moves in all directions to help us fill everything in. We'll get our model. See, they come out pretty nice there. We'll simply convert it to an STL and forward it on. Same thing with the lower. We're going to mount it, scan it, create an STL, and simply send it to AvaDent. So there's my STL files, upper and lower. Where's the bite? No bite is needed at this point. We just need an upper and lower STL. We're not worried about bite relationship at this point. So we're going to go to the AvaDent dashboard. There's two ways you can go into AvaDent. You go through their dashboard or through Connect. The AvaDent dashboard is it comes up with what partner level you join at. So if you go into the higher levels, you go into Connect. If you go into the basic levels, the two base levels, you go into the dashboard. Connect will allow you to manipulate the denture and move the teeth. So you can actually set the teeth yourself pretty much if you want to. With a dashboard, AvaDent is going to do it. They're going to send it back to you for an approval, and you can tell them, rotate the canine, raise or lift the laterals, and they'll make the changes and put it back to you. So depending upon where you want to start at and where you want to go with it, you go into different levels. So we'll talk about the dashboard here. So it asks us what we want, both upper and lower products, or just an upper, just a lower. And then it asks us, you know, what kind of try-in do we want to do? We're going to do a biofunctional, we're going to do I guess it goes into different dentures here, but in the bottom, this is what I was looking for, the advanced try-in, biofunctional try-in, and Wagner try-in. So you have three choices there. The ones I've done have done the Wagner try-in. Not just because he's a friend, I'm very impressed with what it does. Okay, to me, again, going back to Morris, my mentor many years back, make it a great experience for the patient. Okay, with the Wagner try-in, the patient gets to see the teeth. So either we can mill out a try-in tooth, which is tooth shaded, or we can actually use the actual denture tooth in the try-in. Either way, and AvaDent will do it either way for us. So, to me, I like the patient to be able to see what it's going to look like, what the final, you know, let them say, oh yeah, I love the color, I love the shape, that's perfect, that's what I want. With the biofunctional, it works fine, but it's one solid piece denture, it's white in color. Okay, so they can try it in, they can grind on it, They can make marks, move the midline here and whatever else, but it's limited. I don't see it yet, okay? I know other people like it, and to me, the Wagner makes much more sense. I'm not familiar with the ATI one at this point. So it starts asking us details, and we start getting into the how we want the denture produced. And this is the IPNL1, IPNL2, or bonded. Okay. The IPNL1 is IPN denture tooth material, one layer, L1, layer one. The other one's layer two, so we got two layers. So you get a little multi-layer sizal blend in. They're both very good looking. This is their monolithic option. I'm sure you've walked around and you've seen other companies with their pucks where they show the pink and the white, right? They're sellers. They go, oh yeah, look, it's one piece monolithic. My question is, well, how do you avoid getting a pink tooth or a two-shaded papilla? How do you, what happens with these crazy denture, opposing existing dentition and they're odd? How do you get that thing positioned just right in there? AvaDent come up with a great solution. They custom make each disc to match the case. So it's not just a flat layer of each case. So this is what the denture is going to be. Okay, we'll make a disc so it blends in perfectly. So they're gorgeous. They're very strong monolithic. The bonded, that's where they're going to bond the actual IPN denture tooth into the base.
To a milled base.
Into a milled base. Now everybody's asking, well, don't they fall out?
Do each one of these processes cost a little more?
Actually, the IPNL1 is a little lower in price than the other two. So
it goes up in price.
Depending upon what you want, the more stuff you add, of course, the prices are going to change too. So the bonded teeth, people ask, well, don't they fall out? Don't the teeth come unbonded? How strong are they? Well, I've seen denture teeth fall out of press pack and injected dentures too. So if you don't clean them up, if you don't take the wax off, if you don't scuff them up a little bit, they don't bond right. They can fall out. But with the process being done right, they work. And I've seen ones that AvaDent do in Scottsdale, and they do a great job. They don't come out.
Yeah, they have actually. I asked the same question because it's kind of the urban myth that teeth fall out and they're bonded in. They've had very, very, very few teeth fall out of the system. Thousands of these teeth, of these dentures.
Now they've gone to the new HIPAA material.
They're using HIPAA, which you've got to look at. That's a great solution to bonding.
The HIPAA material is a portable material, but they're using it to bond the teeth in. It's extremely strong. It does not yellow or discolor. So it's very impressive. So all three products, very impressive. And Doc, you're telling me you use the monolithic mostly.
Well, I use monolithic because the tooth and the base are one piece of resin. I use them on all my implant cases. I don't have pop-outs because they can't pop out. And the tooth, because it's the same material, is adding to the strength rather than lessening the strength of the base. So with anything where you're doing a hybrid, I always now do the monolithic, either one layer or two layers, and I found them to be very, very
so we're looking at Lucidone 199 base acrylic with IPN denture tooth material bonded in one paint.
Yeah.
And we had a situation, he asked me the day, do you know how they make it? I was like, no, tell me how they make it.
I said, my answer was, I have no idea.
He said, I thought you knew.
So I go over it's a big secret process. That room is locked.
People don't get to see it, but every once in a while, how do they make that disc? From what I understand, it's under extreme pressure.
Right.
They got a technique that we don't know about yet. So the measurements we need, Doc.
Okay, for my little technique, we're going to do that papillometer at rest. We're going to do the smile measurement, and we're going to give them two other ones. How much incisal display do you want to see in that final denture? A young person, when they have their mouth at rest, you see maybe up to 3 millimeters of incisal exposure. In someone like myself, when I rest my mouth, you don't see any of my teeth. It changes with age. So you could either make adjustments to the length of the tooth if you want, working with a younger person, or somebody that wants to look a little younger, you could fill that in.
We're also going to ask, how much display of gingiva do you want to see above the central incisor? Typically, we try to hit it right at the smile line, but that doesn't work for everyone. You'll be able to apply that, and then they can apply it to the final product.
I see this as marketing potential, because how easily I can make up a prescription for the doctors asking them for these simple measurements and a few other simple questions. Doc, I'm going to make your life so easy.
Right.
Let me show you how to do it.
Right.
So, very easy to do.
It's a checklist.
Right. Different setups you can select on the dashboard, customizations. Now, of course, we all know that these, I call these the Euro look. Okay. Europeans like to twist them and move them. Down in the corner, we have the American look. Straight, shiny, and what shade are they? American standard, toilet bowl white, right? So, anyway, that's what the Americans want. They want them straight and pretty. Hey, I'm getting a new denture. I want those, my teeth to be perfect. We can do it. But if you want to customize, they can do it. Posterior setup, again, you know more about that than
well,
I do.
The little guide that I'm going to show you is flat plane. I don't use flat plane occlusion. I like lingualized occlusion. I think that's my opinion. I think it's the best system for AvaDent, for a digital denture, because we're not really doing a face bow. We're not taking lateral bite records, which would allow us to develop a fully functional bilateral occlusion. But I use lingualized myself, but this is where you make the choice.
Well, with the Dentspy Sirona AvaDent dashboard, you can do this from any computer. So again, what material do we want to make it out of? It's going to be Lucitone 199, but you can select the shades. They do have all the different shades available. Do you want stippling? Do you want rugae? The rugae is cool, how they do the rugae. Because they're going to copy the patient's rugae and put it on the denture. It's just not a pattern that they put on there. They copy the patient's and put it up on top, so they're going to feel their own. It's probably not a big deal, but it's kind of cool. Post-palatal seal. Again, up to you guys, what do you feel? Again, I'm going to put it in there because to me it's much easier to remove it than to put it on. So, base plate trough, if you want a base plate to set up on, we'll talk about those a little bit. And anything, other comments? So it gives us our overview. Let's see what we're going to submit. And off it goes. Now this is the AvaDent Connect software, all right? So now you see we're going to get into the ability to where we can manipulate all these teeth. We can move them in, out, up, down, twist them, turn them, whatever we need to do to make a custom setup. So this one, so you go through your teeth and whatever else you want. Now this is where...
All right. You could send a try-in for them. The great thing about AvaDent Dentspy Sirona is you can actually send in any form of information that a traditional setup, for instance, or a denture that was made from a copy of an old denture. Once they get the data, they can then position these teeth. For my Wagner try-in, I'm going to position these virtually. We'll show them how they're done, but they can be positioned in any way you want.
Computer-aided engineering. We're all familiar with CAD and CAM, computer-aided design, computer-aided manufacturing. AvaDent calls it computer-aided engineer because they're going to engineer your denture. They're going to make it correct. They're going to use a computer and their knowledge, vast knowledge, to make a denture that's done right. So they call it engineering instead of CAD.
All right, now we've taken and we've scanned the maxilla, we scanned the mandible. For the guide that we're going to create for appointment two in my technique, we're going to use these bases, these unarticulated casts, and attempt to give a rough articulation using cast analysis that goes back to Gysi, our fellow that we saw in the first photos. From that, we're going to be able to position our maxillary anterior teeth on an occlusal plane based a lot on the Swiss dent concepts. The idea of using that Swiss dent wax former and placing the
4 millimeter troughs into the hamular notches. We're going to sort of do that virtually. We've got this measurement from incisal papilla down to the incisal edge of the central incisors, and then we actually make a virtual, not an actual, but a virtual base plate. Looks something like this. So now we've got a plate of occlusion, anterior, posteriorly. We use the hamular notches, the pterygomaxillary notches, to parallel the horizontal plane. We don't use the eyes, we just use the anatomic features inside, which works great. And then we start setting teeth on top of it to make this guide that I'm going to suggest.
Okay, so we have two different things here. We have AvaDent engineered and AvaDent designed. Right now, AvaDent engineered is available. Okay, you can start today from what I understand. AvaDent engineered is them pretty much doing the work for you. Okay, they're going to mill it out. That's their mill there. They'll set up the setup for you. They'll set up the bite rooms for you, do the try-ins, and they'll process the final thing. The cost is a bit higher because they're doing all the work. But you got to remember, you have zero labor. Okay, you're not doing any of the work other than scanning. You're not stocking denture people. You're not purchasing acrylic. You're not buying pumice or a pressure pot or any of this stuff that's involved. So yes, it costs a little bit more to have them do it, but you save on the other end also. So it's a good option.
Well,
Sorry, we go back?
Yeah, let's go back just so I can go through here. I'm going to kind of follow this track with this try-in here. The biofunctional is the one that's the solid piece. I just want to tell you what the advanced try-in. That's actually a base with teeth set into wax. You can't manipulate them very much, but you can manipulate it a little bit. So that's the difference.
With the Wagner trying, they're using a clip, right?
Yeah.
So they can be moved.
Let me go through this real quick. We sent those three bits of information into AvaDent. They then mill a maxillary base out of the tooth shade that we select, not pink, but tooth shade. But it fits just like the final product. It's just right in. Do the same thing on the bottom, and then they mill facsimiles of your portrait teeth in that same resin. This isn't the final denture. This is a guide that will be constructed to make that final denture. Yes, sir?
How accurate is that bite that they produce?
The base, you mean?
No,
the bite. When they calculate the bite?
We're just using, it's an average position for the teeth at this point. No. We don't have a bite yet.
Okay. Question for you. Mm-hmm. With that custom tray, why couldn't you incorporate the tracer at that point so you would actually have a bite?
You could. If you want to do it that way, they'll do that. They'll take that.
Yeah, that whatever way you want to make the denture is fine.
But what we're trying to get to is get the doctor to 3 30-minute appointments.
Yeah, because when you do that, because that's how they started with it.
Right.
If you do that and you give them the midline already, you have everything that you need.
You can give them a lot of information.
Yeah. Well, I think this will make sense for you as we go along. All these pieces are then assembled into a facsimile denture. Teeth are positioned in an average position, representing the portrait teeth. They're not, they're milled. The base has a group of teeth, 22 to 27 in one block, thin in the back, so you can position that because we want to get aesthetic try-in appointment too. All these are assembled either by your lab or the labs at AvaDent, and that's sent back to the patient or to the doctor appointment too. We haven't even taken a record yet. We've just set these in averages. Now, personally, I have always found, this is where this came from, is I always found it was easier for me to make records when I had teeth in place. At the try-in, I would do my finessing of occlusion, maybe even take some sort of position it carefully. So I always found that when I got the base rim removed, I had teeth in, I could do better record making. So what I'm trying to do is optimize the situation for the new dentist, make it the easiest possible environment for them to make those records. I find it's easier to do it with teeth, so that's what we're doing here.
I got to tell you, the cases I see come in a lot of times, I'm lucky to get a midline mark. The doctor, you know, somebody who comes back, it looks like they didn't even try them in the mouth. You know, it's like, you know, they didn't glue it together, they didn't change anything, you know. So if I can find a way to do it that I can make it easy on them to give me the a little bit of information that I can do to give them a great product, it's a great thing for them. It's easy to do. I want to point out is when it mills here, and again, this is the AvaDent mill. You can see the denture teeth are actually being milled in it, okay, right along with it. So you can do the trying teeth that way.
Here's just another example. Biofunctional Wagner triad, just maybe a
right. Yeah, see, and that's what it's talking about, the biofunctional. It's one solid piece. They could try it in. It's white. It doesn't show the patient a whole lot. Yeah, it feels good, or it feels off. It works. People use it. So, engineered by AvaDent. So the milled base plate, nice product, nice to use. This is a processed Lucitone base plate. So it's milled out. At try-in, the patient's going to get to feel what the final denture it feels like, because it is part of the final denture. This will be processed too, and will become part of the final restoration.
It's a process based on
steroids. So if you feel good, I want to do my setup, I want to do the thing, but I really like the idea of a digital fit. You can do that with a base plate.
Right.
The biofunctional try-in, milled monolithic. And again, the Wagner try-in. This is, again, from what I've seen, they were kind enough to bring me down to Scottsdale to talk to them and show me and ask me to start testing this up for them. And at the time, I went in skeptical. I really did. And my wife was too. It's just like, hey, it just doesn't make sense what they're doing. And then when I saw this process, I'm like, oh, light bulb, yeah, boom, there it is. Now it makes sense. Now I could see how I could do this. I could see how I could give my a better product, and I could make money doing it. Further try-in options are available. Large assortment of options. I think I'm turning Irish there. Large assortment of try-ins.
It does say that.
Yeah, did I drop? Gotta check the spelling. Designed by AvaDent. Okay, this is where we're gonna get the mill. That's my MCX5 mill. Those are not my hands, it's my wife who insisted on wearing rubber gloves because she didn't get her nails done before. So just do it like you. I did not get my nails done. It's not happening. So anyway, we can now, I have been milling them, it works. There needs to be some fine tuning of the programs, but it's coming, okay? The cam is being tweaked. It will be available this summer to where you will be able to mill these in-house. I use the MCX5 wet dry mill. It does mill this material wet. And we found the advantage of milling it wet is that it comes out very smooth and it's very easy on your equipment. Coming summer of 2017. Please, of course, don't hold me to that because I'm just telling you what they told me. So again, we can do the mill base plate in-house, the try-in in-house, the Wagner try-ins in-house. These are designed, not engineered. The clinical appointment too, Doc.
Okay, so we're looking at our next approximate 30-minute appointment. And again, I say approximate because I believe this comes with time, a little practice. First thing we're going to do is fit the base to the patient, just like we would do. These bases usually fit exquisitely well, may need a little adjustment. Maybe you would adjust the flange for patient comfort. You adjust that. That's the first step you're going to do. The second step we're going to do is take a look at the teeth that are already set for the doctor. And this is a typical example. These teeth, I think I must have tweaked these laterals a little bit. They look high. But I put it in, I evaluate the midline. Most of the time, that midline's right on. These central incisors are positioned in an average position. Sometimes I want to push them up. Sometimes I want to pull them down, back, forth. I can do it in Eclipse resin. I don't have to heat it. I just warm it in a little water. The dentist can then position those teeth phonetically, aesthetically. We're doing exactly what could be done in the dental school technique. Horizontal plane, if it's not quite right, it's usually pretty darn close. Line it up with the eyes, push them up on one side, pull it down, midline off a little bit, just move them over, just shift them. Real fast, 5 minutes, 10 minutes at the most.
I want to talk a little bit about this base plate, though, real quick, because it is a milled base plate. It's the exact same milling that's going to come out of the final Lucitone denture. Okay, so the patient's going to feel what it feels like. And if it doesn't fit right at this point, we can also do a reline impression on it and then that's rescan that and send that to them for an improved fit.
Well, the big thing for me is that word process, because that gives you a stable platform to take those records. And I think that was one of the errors that we have from inexperienced dentists, is that they have bases that fit okay. We didn't want to destroy the cast to make them. So they're okay, they have to glue them in, they have to make excuses why they're not fitting. These things fit as well as the final denture, and you can make accurate records because of it. Now, here I am on the other side, examining the length of that tooth. I think that tooth is a little long for a man his age. So I just pushed it up a little bit. Now, he may like it, and he'll have the opportunity to look at it, but this is easily changed. I don't have to pop a tooth out, take a wax spatula and melt the thing and push it in. You just, you'll be stunned. It just pushes up so nicely.
So at this point, you're going to give him a mirror and let him say...
Well, pretty soon. I'm not quite ready yet.
Not quite ready.
Because I haven't taken my bite yet, right? Ah. We're at appointment two. I've got these bases. I haven't made any interocclusal records. Well, on the lower one, in this case, I have a material called Alu-Wax. Most of us are familiar with Alu-Wax. It's a wax that warms up in warm water and softens into just a real nice, pliable material. Have the dentist chill the maxillary denture in cold water for a couple minutes, hardens the resin. Then I soften the Alu-Wax, and I go through the normal procedure to make centric and vertical measurements, vertical dimension of occlusion, vertical dimension of rest, whatever they use. They indent the upper teeth into that Alu-Wax and leave a mark. Then we chill that, gently warm the front teeth, and position this group of 22 to 27 into an aesthetic position. Could be functional position too for a speech, but we just position it that way. Then we give the patient a mirror. What do you think? How does it look? Because we set teeth from bye to bye, we're missing the second premolar here, but we have molars. They can really get a good sense of what the denture is going to look like. Now, I should preface all of this. This is for simple denture patients, and it's not for patients that should be referred to a prosthodontist. You need to tell your dentist that the most important thing you can do for success in your denture making is select the right patient, right? So this is easy for them. This is not somebody that's really picky about this tooth should be a little bit this way or that way. It's a normal patient. They buy in. Then I make a liberal, once they say okay, I make a liberal interocclusal record using Regisseal or Blue Mousse, something like that. A lot of it, so it locks it in place. Then the patient is dismissed. This, in my office, is 15 to 20 minutes. Because I've got the teeth already set. And out they go. This then is shipped back to you, and then you're going to rescan it, as Michael described.
Now, realize that this base here that is milled out of, the puck that's milled out of, is tooth-shaped. So if we're going to do an A2 denture, we're going to use an A2 puck to manufacture. So that way your teeth are tooth-shaped, or you can use a denture tooth. We have the Wagner try-in on the end. The one in the middle is denture records, duplicates of the denture. When we make new dentures for patients, patients already have dentures. If you just start all over, okay, we're going to make a new denture, new occlusal rims, new everything, start fresh. What's the usual reaction of a patient? It doesn't feel like my old one. It's not right. It doesn't feel good. So what happens? They take the new one home, throw it in a drawer, and put the old one back. Because they like the old one. Yes, sir.
I have a question. You talk about new set of denture. If you're just doing one denture, for example, the patient have all the teeth in the lower, and just do the upper. Sometimes we need to customize teeth by teeth, grind. How much do you do that? Because sometimes we don't find space on the plate.
Right.
We need to grind
right.
The plate.
Absolutely, you're correct. And that's worked out. That's one of the big questions I have.
That's my big question.
I got you.
Got it.
Because what happens here, what's going to happen here, and when you go in, you look at the disc that they have in there half done. Because what's going to happen is it's going to move the occlusal side first. All right, you're going to take the disc out, bond the teeth in. Okay? You're going to put the disc back in the mill. It's going to flip over and mill the intaglio side. Right. At the same time, it's trimming the length of the teeth to where it needs to be, the match.
You've got about 3 minutes.
Sorry. Was that?
We're almost at 10, so we got to.
Okay, we got to hustle
through it a little bit.
Okay. So,
hurry up.
Okay, no problem, but it does do it. It mills them in. But again, with the dentures, if I can do a duplicate of their denture and scan it and send it to AvaDent, they'll make it look like the old denture with fresh teeth, fresh acrylic, fit better.
You know, we might want to end right now. It's about 10. We would talk about scanning. We'd talk about the three different Dentspy Sirona options for finishing. I think if we all go next door, take a look at all the stuff there, it might be a way we can describe it. Maybe in more detail we could talk about it in a personal way to kind of get it.
Okay, so we're going to scan the try and get done. Okay, so what I've been taught, I'm supposed to give you a call to action. A good speaker gives a call to action again, okay? So everybody face the person next to them. Say, I'm going to race you into the room next door to look up. That's my evidence. Thank you for coming, guys. Really appreciate your time. We'll be happy to answer any questions for you there.